Yo, what's up, fam? It's your boy, E.T. Hey, y'all been seeing these videos I've been doing where I've been like, what do you want? What do you need? Right? And so, got some feedback. And so, for the S2S podcast, we're going to remove it from its current home, right? And we're going to put it, you know, on its own page, right? So you can do what? Have clear access, a clear path to get everything you need. So do me a favor. Don't embarrass me now. All right? So we're about to separate it. We're going to separate it for you, but make sure you use it. Stop what you're doing right now. Don't be like me. You're going through your phone a year later trying to find somebody's name because you didn't stop right then and put it in. So go to S2S podcast channel right now. All right. Click that link. Get over there. Get subscribed so that everything we got going, announcements, reward, everything is going to come directly to you. All right. So stop what you're doing right now and go sign up. No. I mean right now. Like right now. I was talking to Jalen. He was like, Dad, I posted something. I said, son, it's cotton candy. It has the applause of men have no nutritional value. Ooh. It's Cheeto Puffs.
That's a bar.
When somebody, congratulations.
Let me tell you.
It's Cheeto Puffs, bruh. Here's what matters. Am I in an industry? Am I killing it in the industry? Meaning everybody, bruh. Whoever becomes the president of the United States of America, just know this for a fact. Whoever becomes the president of the United States of America, at least 60 million people thought they was trash.
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the Bayesian sensation, Mr. Karl Wesley Phillips. Karl, what's happening?
Man, what's going on? What it do?
How you feeling, man? It's Jesse's birthday.
Top of the world. Today is my daughter's birthday.
Yeah. And this is always a big day.
Oh, bro, for those that follow the podcast, hopefully y'all understand, but this is also the day that we moved into the house.
Yeah.
So she's 10 today. This is the 10-year anniversary of us moving into the house. And I'll say it like this, the house that I couldn't afford. The house that I looked at and got mad at God at, like, why you gonna show me this knowing that I can't afford it?
Yeah.
And we in there 10 years and let me just say it like this, and we hadn't missed no payments.
Yeah.
Not one.
Yeah, that's
not
a blessing,
one.
Dog. Yeah. What y'all got for the birthday?
Man. So today, and Jessie, she's very low maintenance. So she had just her little list that she made.
Okay.
So the big thing for
you
her.
You said little, but you did like that.
Just a little list.
Trying to figure out.
No, the big thing for her is she's having like a sleepover this weekend. And she's never had, she had one with like one or two of the little neighborhood, you know, girls. Mm-hmm. But she's never had a sleepover where she got friends over and that kind of stuff.
Oh, okay.
So today is cool, but she's all about the weekend.
Yeah,
if you get what I'm saying. So
for sure.
We just got her a couple of things. She got a new bike. She's into crafts, so we got like some boards to paint, you know, like some beads stuff, all that kind of stuff. And then tonight we're just doing dinner. She's into this Indian cuisine.
Yeah.
So it's a restaurant here that's local. It's not Sindhu's. It's another one like Sindhu's. But Sindhu's, it's literally in the same complex, but I swear they're cousins. They literally got to be cousins. Like, they one over here and the other one over there.
Where, East Lansing?
So, East Lansing, in, what was it, Hannah Plaza, I think it was called out there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what's up, man.
But yeah, so we're just going to go out there, just grab some food and,
Good, man. So the reason I wanted to do a pod with just you and I is I had to repent. Let me tell y'all something, man. When you a pilot, sometimes you can get out of control.
Uh-oh.
You know what I'm saying? And I was out of control.
These are my confessions.
Man, you know, exactly. Straight up. So I'm going to be real with you. It was like a couple weeks ago. So long story short, we had a bunch of trips coming up, right? And it was one of those deals where I didn't know, you know, we're going to China. So I didn't know that you had to have a visa to go to China. And so they told us, but I don't know what the process is. I don't know if you get one when you land, whatever. So they said, no, you got to send your passport in. And they hold it for like a week, and then they send it back if you get approved. Well, what's the problem with that? I got Toronto, London, Paris. I got all of these things going
back to
on.
Back.
Yeah. And so I'm like, yo, I can't send mine in. So long story short, I called Jeff and I'm like, yo, I don't know what to do. And Jeff is Toby's best friend, manager, you know, kind of runs Toby's side over there. And we're going to China for Toby. And I was like, bro, I don't know what to do. I can't give up my passport. And he was like, yo, he was like, yeah, that's crazy. I didn't think about that. Well, let me make some calls and do some other stuff. And he was like, you know, I wonder if you could, let's just see if you can get a second passport and, you know, go get it and send yours in. Bro, when I tell you, I shut him down. Now, Jeff is more like Karl in terms of personality. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Cool, easygoing. He don't want no static. He ain't trying to push the envelope. He just like, yo, very like, matter of fact, cool, like, I, whatever. Bro, when I tell you, I was like, Jeff, that has got to be. I mean, just think about it. In my mind, right? I'm a pilot. I'm going, bro, what are the chances? You know how they are with them passports.
Yeah.
You got to send your passport in for 6 months. It take forever. They very tight. On. It's a passport, doggone it. In this day and age, 2024, I'm like, Jeff, your stupid mind would say, go get a second passport. Like, why would you even say that? Like, bro, go find me a real solution, right? Like, I'm on Jeff's head. I'm telling him, like, bro. And he's like, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Listen, I was so convincing as the pilot that I didn't shut him down and had him thinking it wasn't possible, right? So I'm like, yo, go get me another solution. So he was like, all right, yeah, no, that was stupid. That was stupid, yeah. Is anybody feel me? And shout out to the Patreon fam. We got the Patreon fam watching live. If somebody told you just go get a second passport, just like a second one, and send your old one in and use the new one.
I ain't gonna lie, Jason Bourne comes to mind and it sound mad illegal.
It sound illegal.
It sound mad illegal.
It sound like you about to have, right, that's exactly what I'm thinking. Carl, you just painted it so how I'm thinking.
Yeah.
So I shut him down. And this was probably like a couple weeks ago. So, long story short, we was here last time when we was doing the pod and he calls me and he's like, yeah, he's got the Chinese ambassador Visa Express guy.
Got it. On the phone.
On the phone. This is like who's helped, like you hire an agency to help get these passports done. So Jeff calls me and listen, this is what I love about Karl and Jeff type people. Now, if that was me, I would have handed you your butt. I'm
you
talking
trifling
about.
Bruh, fool.
Jeff Call was like, hey, see, so I got my man on the line, and what he's saying is that you can get a second passport. Now, mind you, a whole week then went by from where we were supposed to be.
Yeah.
He says, yeah, it turns out you can just go and get a second passport. I was like, what? I'm on the phone.
Wow.
So my man's explaining. And he's like, yo, I can get a passport. You can get a second passport, but there's only one appointment that fits the timeline before you got to go to Toronto and London and all of this.
Wow.
It's in Detroit at 10 a.m. Now I know what you're thinking. Lucky me. Because look, I don't know if you've ever had to do this before, but like one time Candace, I think, had to go to New Orleans. Like, we go out of the country a lot. So it's, you know, you ain't got time to be sending it in, renewing it. Oh, it take 3 weeks. So anyway, I think one time she had to fly to New Orleans and go to the passport office there. And so anyway, they just tell us Detroit, which sounds like, oh, wow, see, you blessed because you already there. Here go the problem. My wife was not. Bro, I call Candace at 7 p.m. and tell her, call the babysitter and go to the airport right now. I just booked your flight for 10 p.m. You got the last thing out of Atlanta to Detroit. Our passport meeting is at 10 o'clock in the morning, tomorrow morning. Bro, she literally had to drop everything. And I'm talking about, she was like, what kind of foolishness you got me on? Fly to Detroit. I drove from Lansing to Detroit, picked her up from the airport. We get in the hotel about 2 a.m., had an appointment for 10. Long story short, we ended up getting it, of course, you know, but I was like, yo, I had to do all of that because as the pilot, I got out of control and did not listen to the air traffic control when they recommended something because in my own brain, I thought,
no way.
Ain't no. Now, mind you, I don't even know, but I'm just trying to show y'all, like, for those of y'all out there who have a personality like mine, and the reason I want to talk to Karl about it, because Karl and I have grown in trust over the years, but, like, for real, for those of y'all who operate like me, you have to be able to listen to the people around you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could have said, like, we probably could have, I might have got an appointment in Atlanta. I could have had, I wouldn't have had to fly my wife in the middle of the night and have this foolishness going on and have my wife looking at me like I'm crazy had I just listened to Jeff. And I'm like, yo, there's an example. And we all know, you know, the major example, you know, obviously, you know, Kobe Bryant and them, they told the air traffic control, said, yo, it's not safe to fly right now. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, you know, you kind of brush that off. And obviously in that situation, it had life or death consequences. And what we're talking about now, I think it's more like everyday consequences in business, relationships, God forbid, it's nothing to do with life or death, but it's just like, yo, I was, I guess, Karl, frustrated with myself because I found myself in a position where I was like doing better, and then it came out of nowhere where I just shut it down.
Still who you are.
And so I guess, you know, from your side, dealing with somebody like me, how difficult does that make it when you got somebody who is as hard-headed and strong-willed as I am to be like, yo, you doing this wrong, or slow down, or be quiet and let me talk?
And it's crazy because it's, I'm going to say, doggone near impossible.
Mm.
Just because, and again,
yeah,
from my perspective, like, your track record is so good. You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, when CJ said do that, it worked. Mm. When he said do that, it worked. So when I give my idea, like, I'm almost either, number one, expect you to co-sign my idea for it to, we know it's going to work, or I'm looking for your suggestion.
Right,
like,
right.
That's my default. You see what I'm saying? So it's almost impossible when you come with the way, like, again, it's a strength that you come with, right? Just being real, I come with I'm not playing it down, right? Y'all, please don't take it the wrong way. I'm not playing it down. But it's like, no, CJ is coming with a strength and an authority that I don't have. Mm-hmm. I respect that, and I'm going to defer to it 9 times out of 10.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking about it. Let's just go super obvious. You got a passport. That's not going to work. The next obvious thing is, well, maybe get a second one. You see what I'm saying? It's just the next obvious thing.
Yep.
But, and it, man, what's I'm slowing down. Let me slow down because I'm saying, I wonder how many ideas each of us had that could have been.
Well, no, I'm saying I get all my ideas too. You know what I'm saying? No, I'm just being real.
I'm just saying this for Patreon too. Like, how many ideas do you have?
Yeah, okay, you're talking to them. I was going to say, all my ideas that I got, they get executed.
Bro, how many ideas do you have that you just didn't follow through on because, like, you know what, I don't know if that makes sense and all that. And that's something that we really got to think about. Because truthfully, like, immediately you said it, my mind went to Jason Bourne. Like, oh, no, that's, what's my man, Catch Me If You Can. Like, you got multiple passports.
And by the way, it is illegal to travel with both. Like, illegal. It's illegal. Like, you can only have one. If they catch you with both of them, you're in trouble.
Oh, wow.
But you can get a second one. And let me tell you something. My man grilled us at the joint and was like, why you need a second passport? Where you going again? Let me see your travel itinerary again. And imagine my dumb butt at the passport office. And let me tell you something. I probably shouldn't even say this, but listen.
All right, S2S fam, let's get real for a second. We all know how crazy life can get with work, family, and everything in between. But here's the thing, if we don't take care of ourselves now, it's only gonna catch up with us later. And that's why we're such big fans of Organifi. Their superfood products are all about helping us take care of our health today so we can enjoy a better quality of life tomorrow. Of course, you know one of our all-time favorites is the green juice, right? It's packed with ingredients like moringa, chlorella, spirulina, and these are all agents that help detoxify the body and provide natural energy. Seriously, it's a game changer when it comes to getting your daily greens in. And if you're looking for that natural energy boost, you've got to check out the red juice, guys. It's filled with antioxidants from berries, helping you to stay energized without that caffeine crash. And the best part, guys, this week only, from October 18th to 20th, when you grab any 2 pouches of Organifi products, you'll get a free gold chocolate, and that's perfect for winding down at the end of a long day. It's packed with turmeric and other soothing ingredients to help you relax and recover. All right, so stop waiting, guys. Head over to Organifi.com/success and use the promo code SUCCESS to save 20% off your order because you rock with the S2S podcast. And listen, remember, that free gold chocolate deal is available from October 18th to 20th. So whenever you buy two pouches, you get that free gold chocolate. So that's Organifi, Organifi.com/success. Start taking care of your health today for a better tomorrow. This episode of the Secrets to Success podcast is brought to you by BetterHelp. We all face fears, whether it's the fear of failure, fear of rejection, or even the fear of not living up to our own potential. While Halloween is an attempt to make facing fears fun, the real ones can hold us back. Therapy can help you confront those fears head on. If you've ever felt like you're wearing a mask, hiding parts of yourself, therapy can help you embrace your true self. It's not just for those dealing with trauma, it's for anyone who wants to grow, learn positive coping skills, and become their best self. BetterHelp is convenient, flexible, and 100% online. All you have to do is fill out a brief questionnaire that'll get you matched with a licensed therapist. And guys, if for any reason you and that therapist don't gel, you can switch therapists at any time for no additional charge. Take the mask off with BetterHelp and start your journey today. Visit BetterHelp.com/success to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/success.
99.9% of the time, me and my wife are on the one accord.
Same page.
So with China, right? We're going to China, first of all. This is a communist country. They got different rules.
Yeah.
So my man was like, at the passport office, was like, are you going for work or leisure?
Yeah.
And I was like, in my head, I made a split decision. First of all, I'm not working.
Right.
Per se.
Yeah.
Toby got to work. I'm there. I'm about to go to the Great Wall of China. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what I'm going to do. But, you know, y'all know Toby and Ebo, you know, that I'm their safety blanket for both of them. So if I'm not there, they cry. So I'm going, you know what I'm saying? I got to be there for them. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. But my man says, and I say, leisure. At the same time, Candace says, work. And I looked at her and I was like, no, I'm not working. And she was like, yes, you are. And I was like, no, I'm not. I'm like, because in my mind, I'm like, okay, are they going to say you need a work visa?
Visa, yeah.
Like, you, like this ain't the right type of, I don't know what they're going to say. So I'm like, but technically I'm not working. But she like, in her head, I think she thinks it's better to say you're going to work. And so I gave her the look and was like, no,
we're not working.
I'm going for fun. And so we sitting there kind of beefed out at the passport office. And finally afterwards, I told her and she was like, oh, I'm sorry, but I didn't get what you were saying. Whatever. But anyway, my man's like, so you going, and I'm, and like I said, my stupid butt, he like, what do you do for a living? I was like,
how do you answer that?
A podcast, and, you know, Eric Thomas. And then he was like, well, what is going on in China? And I was like, Toby. And then, you know, he's a rapper. And, bro, it was just all bad. But, you know, I sat down. The fate of our Chinese trip future was in the hands of some random little white man in the passport office. And then he was like, hey, go sit. You know, they kind of like, they kind of act a little, because I think they want to try to see what was ever. So he was kind of acting tough. Bit. And then finally he was like, Quinny's. And he called us back up there. He was like, y'all good to go. Boom, boom, boom. He was real cool. And we got our second passport.
Mm.
So we had to mail the first ones in.
Yeah.
And then travel to Europe with our
second,
our brand new ones. So I was like, oh, is that going to raise some red flags? My kids got passport stamps out the world. And then me and my wife randomly got the exact same renewal. But that's neither here nor there, because at the end of the day, I guess we could have renewed at the same time. But in my mind, Carl, I just couldn't even fathom that being a good idea. And like I said, shout out to Jeff for not killing me, because I would have. Imagine like Maul doing that and then me calling Maul and being like, you dumb son of a. And so anyway, I guess for you, you saying how many times do you have ideas that you, you know, don't get off, or things that you want to say? How have you learned to navigate that process?
So I think, is that the hip hop preacher?
Oh, we got a visitor.
Live and direct. Come on in, sir. Yeah. So the beauty of it, see, is number one, the thing to realize is that we all have blind spots. Mm-hmm. That's the thing to realize. So When I think about it, I'll go back to, let me get this story and then I'll come back to what you asked. The when I first got that Nikon camera, you remember it in a couple of seconds. Yeah. I got this Nikon camera. E and I had to do something downtown Detroit. Mm-hmm. And I took this photo of E. I'm talking about right outside the stadium. You remember it? You remember? I'll keep talking.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I do remember.
So that's what I'm saying.
Exactly.
Blind spots. So when I tell y'all, I took this photo of E. I just got this Nikon. Like, again, we've been borrowing cameras.
This was portrait mode before portrait mode.
Before portrait mode. But I tell y'all the best 100%. Photo I ever took in my life to this day.
Yeah.
I'm just like, yo, see. I sent C the photo and C's like, yo, it's a fire photo, but we can't use it. And I'm like, you must have just lost your mind, C. Hey. When I tell you, and I listen to y'all, when I tell y'all everything in this photo, the lighting is everything perfect. E standing there. I think E was pointing. He had like a football in his
football,
hand or something.
Yeah.
And it was just, when I tell y'all, perfect. And C's like, yo, go look at the photo again. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, the lighting is incredible, y'all. Like, look at the framing, everything. He's like, Karl, look at the photo again. I'm like, see, I don't know what you're talking about, bro. I can't see it.
Crazy.
Bruh. Big and Bull, y'all. Spoiler alert. Big and Bull behind E is like a Bud Light. I'm talking about like the hugest Bud Light poster you ever seen in your life. I did not see it. I was so focused on this image, making sure it looked crisp. So going back to you, I'm just saying, number one, let's be aware that we all have blind spots. Major blind. I'm saying like I cannot see. It's right there. It's not even like it was small in the corner, y'all. It was huge right next to E's head. Yeah. Right. So
But I also think that it's easier going this way to that way because I don't have a problem saying anything to you.
Facts.
So I can just be like, Karl, what you doing? Like, it don't bother me. You know what I'm saying? But if I would have came with that kind of fire and enthusiasm, you might have been like, hey, see,
it's all right.
You'd have been like, are we cool with the Bud Light? You wouldn't even have said it like, take it out and eat. Just for those of y'all just listening and not watching, E has joined us. So E, I give you the 2 second version.
Martin, you knew, what up?
You knew most of this, honestly.
You on live.
You knew most of it, honestly, from last time. But you remember how I had to go get that emergency passport?
Yeah.
I don't know if I told you, but Jeff was the one who told me like 2 weeks ago, a week before that, you might be able to go get a second passport. Right. And when I tell you how to buy custom out, I said, bruh, what kind of stupid foolishness is that?
Right.
Oh, I murdered him. I'm talking about Jeff. You think they're going to let a bruh run around the country internationally with two passport. American passports? Bruh, you can't even get, it's hard. It took Karl 100 years to get one. Bruh, you think they finna let me get to, I shut him down. Bruh, he called me back the day before I ended up having to fly Canada. He called me back with the dude on the line, was like, yeah, so what you got to do is get a second passport. Here's everything you knew. I said, oh my. Bro, it was the pilot gone wild. And I was talking about, you know, obviously, you know, we talked about Kobe and, you know, we've talked about that before. But I was telling Karl, like, yo, I felt myself doing that old CJ again where I felt stupid because I'm like, yo, now I got to fly my girl up here. She had to leave the kids. We had to pay a babysitter. We got to do all of this extra moving and shaking. It was stressful. Didn't nobody get no rest. She was tired. We had to pack for, you know, upcoming trips and stuff like that. And I'm like, wow, like, again, with the communication boy, me not being available for feedback in that sense. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yo, I got to quit doing that. And I feel like for a long time, my reputation, it's like the dude who used to knock people out on the block, but then he got saved.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He like a Christian now. He go to church. And then it's like people still be like, hey, here he come. And you're like, whoa, I'm not like that more.
Yeah, Paul,
but then I just knock somebody back out.
No question.
And I'm like, ooh, I felt that thing. Like, bro, you're going to have to repent and go back because something in you still is not feeling when people tell you something that you don't want to hear. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I was just asking Karl about, you know, our relationship over the years, how, for real, bro, I was a terror back in the day. I really didn't want to hear nothing. And now I would say, I still don't, clearly, because I got to go back and deal with that.
Yeah.
But, like, my pilot, sometimes it has blind spots that I still, that I thought I got rid of, that's still there.
And there's a reason why, you know. And again, I do want you guys to understand, I don't talk about this a lot, but I do want you to understand you cannot make money if you're not going to be a pilot. So just, like, if you have a problem with being a pilot, you have a problem economically, okay? So just know that, okay? Just know that, yo, I don't want to work on my pilot, meaning I don't want to be aggressive. I don't want to be driven. I don't want to be demanding. So you got two things. Either like, okay, I'm cool with that and I'm going to be broke, right? Or I'm going to be a pilot and piss people off, but I'm going to be straight. You know what I'm saying? As for me and my house, we're going to be good.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And you really have to resolve that. And I say that because I think for my wife, her pilot and flight, and her air traffic control, they collide sometimes. Mm-hmm. And so a air traffic control is a major thinker. Like, they think through everything.
Yep.
So it will make Didi think through her pilot, because it's like, okay, we winning, but people not feeling good. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so it's funny because she said to me the other day, like, with the church, you know her frustration with the church. And so I was like, oh, okay, yeah, no. She's like, yeah, I feel like me and Candace is whatever. And I was like, oh, no, I'm clear. I could bring CJ on. Like, I'm 100% clear. Yep. I said, but the problem is, if CJ come, 90% of the people going to get fired. And they're going to be gone. Yeah, period. You know what I'm saying? Like
94%.
Right.
To be exact.
Right. 94 people going to be gone.
Oh, bro.
I'm just keeping it 1,000.
Yeah.
Because they can't operate at that level. You know, so Didi, be clear. I'm doing this because of this. You feel what I'm saying?
Can I say? Don't lose your train of thought.
Yeah, I won't.
What he said is true. It's absolutely true. My problem is not that you can't operate at that level. It's the problem that you can't operate that level and you have an opinion.
Right.
Okay, sorry. I want to put that amendment in there. Because a lot of people, you can't operate at that level, but you low. Listen, man. Josh said it. You either can make money or take away stress.
Right. It's
the only two things you can get paid for.
Yeah.
So you not making no money and you adding stress.
Yeah. Mm.
So now you done broke the two golden rules.
Golden rule.
I'm just saying, of any business or anything that we're running.
Relationship.
If you can't take away stress.
Yeah.
Listen, I will pay you to take away stress. I have an assistant whose job it is to take away stress. I have an assistant. Her job is to say, you know, you got a Zoom call in an hour. Okay, cool. Then she calls in 30 minutes and go, your Zoom is in 30 minutes. Then she calls me 2 minutes before the Zoom and goes,
link.
Here go the link for the Zoom. Yeah. Are you? And then, let me tell you something. Camden got so sweet with it. She gets on the Zoom to make sure I show up. And they'd be like, oh, do we have somebody else on the Zoom? She'd be like, nope, just saying hi, bye. And she get off the Zoom.
No question.
I'm saying, so now my stress is being taken away. She not making me no money per se, but by her taking stress off me, I'm able to generate more.
Yeah.
So that I just wanted to be fair because people are going to be like, wow, CJ just firing people. No, either you're taking away stress or you're adding revenue. And let me tell you something. Let's look at it in football terms or something like that. You got a player who, you know, he partying, he out all night. He may be getting in a little bit of trouble, but he putting up 3-4 touchdowns.
Easy.
I'm just saying.
He on
it. Seemed like it's
he
a
on the
bit,
squad.
Bruh.
He on the squad.
Leave my man alone.
He not getting in trouble. He going to be on the team.
You see what I'm saying?
Because I'm going to lose my job anywhere if he gone.
Right. Okay. Right. And guess who else
so he got
on the team?
To stay.
The other person staying on the team is the camaraderie guy who making everybody fit. Like, dang, like, he got the second string quarterback.
He got the
starter back. He making sure
easy.
Everybody.
Bruh.
He helping with the playbook. He got the call.
Yeah.
He taking away stress from the starter. He coming back to the starter like, hey.
How to make money, y'all.
Bruh.
So you can understand where we go. Or how to be in bliss. One of the two.
So I'm just saying, I'll go back to what you were saying, but I want people to know why you get fired around me.
No question.
It don't have nothing to do with me being evil. I don't like people.
Okay, no. So I shouldn't say. Okay, so look, I shouldn't say this. I got here late. So I shouldn't say this. I should have said it to CJ first so C can say it to y'all, right? Because I don't like saying stuff and being a co-signer for stuff that could be evil, right? I don't like being a co-signer for evil.
Yeah.
You feel me? But.
Yeah.
I don't have a choice. I got to, it just happened. So I got to tell y'all.
Come on.
Bruh. Again, cosign, do not do as I do. Do not do what I do. Just take the lesson.
Come on.
Bruh, we in Italy. And so we got a little extra time because it's like, you know what I'm saying? When you're in a different country on a different time zone, you don't go to sleep like that, normal. You don't go to sleep, especially we don't. We don't got kids. So it's just like, we up.
Yeah, yeah.
But we can't watch state TV because half of it is Arabic, half of it is Italiano, whatever that is,
yep.
a little bit of Spanish, a little bit of Russian. They got all kind of stuff on TV. It's yep. it's weird. It's not
they got,
like it.
They got one channel that's in English, and all they play is How I Met Your Mother.
That's it.
Like that, that's I promise.
And they got. So, wow. so, but what they do have is Netflix.
Oh, no doubt.
Right? Yeah, yeah, and I realized yeah. Netflix is yep. everywhere because Netflix is a library.
Yep.
So before I used to always be like, why they only got Netflix? Because it's a library.
Yep.
And so you ain't even see all the stuff that was on it. So
yep.
anyway, I don't know how I watched this show. I don't know how I watched it. Okay, I do. All right, here's another way to make money. You have to know exactly every move. It's like chess. You got to know every single move. Listen to me. I say this because I love you. I know for a fact the people who don't make money is when you call them and ask for something, they say they don't know. That is the quickest way to be broke is you don't know. And you don't mean no harm when you say it. It just means you don't know. There is no money in behind I don't know. Like, it's no money behind that. Like, there is no clear path to success
yep.
when you don't know. So stop saying that. If you don't know, make up something, okay? Just make up something, right? Because you don't know. Like, for real, it's not bad. But, like, if you don't know where you're going and you pull over and ask a dude who from the city, hey, how do I get to so-and-so? He say, I don't know. Bruh, you about to be crushed because you had one lifeline
yep.
and the lifeline told you they didn't know. You feel me? So that's a sidebar. So I shouldn't be saying this, but I do know now how we watched it. So I'm like, okay, my girl loves to watch crime stuff, Force 48, whatever. I'm not going to have her watch First 48 because she watched all of those. It wouldn't be good to be in Italy and watch the first four. You already watched that.
Miss so like, Mason. I stopped watching after Miss Mason. She was the best.
Bro, she was the best.
Now, you know you done did it. Now, go ahead and tell me before I sit over there and slap you.
You're right.
Oh, bro, she used to have them.
Shut the case.
Why do I know her? Because of DD.
Oh,
so,
Miss
so
Mason.
So I said, you know what? I'm going to find something that, yeah. I was like, heist. I'm gonna find.
Oh yeah, Heist is good. Yeah, y'all watched the first season.
Okay, so watch that.
I watched
not
Heist.
That though.
We watched first season.
Okay,
of Heist.
But
that
not
was COVID.
That. Yeah, but yeah, I didn't see it. But not that.
It was good.
I watched Heist, which is a documentary on real people that got away
oh,
with murder.
Oh, okay, got
so
you.
Then after that, but they show if you like this, you're gonna love this. You feel me? You gonna love this. So I watched Heist. Listen to me, bruh.
Not the show. Now you're talking about the show.
Now I'm talking about the show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I didn't finish it. I think we might got an episode or two. Let me tell you something. I'm done with humans. I'm done. The movie showed me you do not have what it takes. Bruh, I am done. Listen to me. Now I'm not telling you to go watch that, but go watch that, okay? Go watch that and figure out what you are and fix it. When Karl talked about blind spots, I'm like, bruh, I'm done. I'm done doing marriage counseling. I'm done marrying people.
Wow.
I told Zanita, don't. 4 or 5 months ago, don't call me about getting married. Don't call me no more about getting counseling. Don't call me to get on the APOC.
What about divorce?
Don't call me about nothing. I'm done. After I watched the show, I'm like, yo, I'm done with human beings. I can't tell y'all the show just in case you didn't watch it, but watch this. My man was an air traffic control. He gave specific instructions. Them idiots did everything he said don't do. Every single thing he said don't do. Every single thing he said don't do. And to CJ's point, here's the crazy part. When you let people do stuff, some kind of way they feel like they know what they're doing. Even though you couldn't do it on your own. Look, I'm trying to humble somebody. If you don't know what you're doing, do not let nobody tell you to make decisions. It's the stupidest thing you could do. The only reason you're trying to make decisions is because you've grown. If you are not a good decision maker, stop making them. And connect with somebody who is, and don't you ever question them because you don't have the authority to question. Listen to me. I promise y'all, I'm done. Like, I already quit as a pastor. I quit. I'm only preaching now. I'm like, let the assistant run, y'all.
This
the
best social media outtakes I'm going to have from me ever.
Oh, for sure. Absolutely.
I'm done. No, I'm being real. I'm done. Why? Because I realize you have two types of leaders. I'm sorry. You have two types of followers. One of the groups is 90%, and the other one is only 10%. You have one group that realizes that their job is to take orders from you and carry them out. You have another group, which is the 90% of the world, who are only with you because they can't do it on their own. And now they're using your resources and your whatever to do their own thing.
Have you ever wondered what the secret ingredients are to a successful business? Sure, it's the people, the planning, and the product, of course, but an often overlooked secret is actually the business behind the business. And for millions of businesses, that business is Shopify. Shopify is home to the number one checkout in the world. Whether your customers are scrolling through social media, browsing your website, or walking into your store, Shopify ensures that you're ready to sell. And with features like Shop Pay that boost conversions by up to 50%, you're turning more visitors into loyal customers, meaning more sales and fewer abandoned carts. We use Shopify ourselves, of course, all our grind gear books, right? It's a game changer, guys. Upgrade your business and get the same checkout we use with Shopify. So are you ready to turn that into a daily soundtrack? Sign up for your $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/secret-to-success, all lowercase. That's shopify.com/secret-to-success to upgrade your selling today.
It's I promise y'all, it's 90%. I have people at the church who have never made any decisions about 90% of the stuff we're doing, and they having calls and meetings about it. They talking amongst themselves about something they have never done. I'm like, why are you talking about something? This is where the GED makes you dope. I don't talk about stuff I don't know. Like, I speak for a living. I don't try to do anything else. I don't make any decisions about lighting. I call the lighting people. I don't touch a camera. I don't push record. The only thing I work on this room is the doggone Rodecaster. And why? Because there's a button you push that says record, it's red. When it's not red and those numbers are not moving and the equalizer, if that's what you call it, if them jokers ain't jumping while I'm talking, that's the way I know it does not work. I hit a camera, I have no idea when I hit that button, and I sit here, I have no idea if that joker is doing anything while I'm sitting here for an hour. So listen to me very closely.
Hey, I'm laughing because I'll come in here randomly and Ewa had a Rodecaster still plugged in, still on. He record. Just did what he get.
Yeah,
and go.
I'm
not so he's not even making this up, y'all. He legit. Yeah.
I'm not. All I
yeah, because I don't know if I got to hit record the end or stop,
bruh.
Or which one delete.
Because if I hit so just it might blow everything out. And so I just know how to take the thing.
Like, you hit record again?
Nope.
I just left it
and
record.
Eddie will ask me, do we have separate files? You separate them jokers however you want to separate them. I talk.
I got one.
I got one.
I got the one I need.
Once. You keep going, there's going to be a pause.
Yeah.
When there's a pause, you know I stopped. You start all over again wherever you want to start. But I'm not stopping, starting.
So you mean to tell me because you ET and you the owner of the company, you can't just do everything?
Bruh, I cannot. And so please hear this part. I'm sorry. Somebody talking. All right. Okay. I got you. All right. Martin, I don't know who either. Y'all them looking just like you. I don't know who it is and why they're speaking, but we're going to push mute. We're going to mute them out. Listen to me very closely, y'all. How to make money or how to, all right. So y'all got to hear this one. So I watched the show. I'm done, y'all. I have lost all hope. When I tell y'all,
welcome to 2016.
Bruh, when I tell y'all.
I'm about to go watch it tonight because I still need this.
When I tell y'all,
yeah, it's good.
This dude came up with the perfect.
Oh, he had the strategy perfect. Mm.
Humans. All you had to do was what he told you to do. Mm. Humans, bruh. And you could see each person. That, man, me and Didi went through that thing because, you know, Didi, she the professor. So yeah. She pissed.
Oh, for sure.
Bruh, this is how I knew she was. This is how I know she's sick.
Yep.
Bruh. Can you tell me what she's, take a wild guess. Do you know what was the best scene for her?
Oh, I have seen it. It's been 4 years since I seen it. Three, 4 years. I don't remember.
None of it.
What you mean?
You don't remember
I'm saying bits and pieces, but I couldn't tell you like verbatim.
I'll never forget the movie. Yeah. Bruh, she said her favorite part was the classroom scene.
Yeah. When they was educating them on the, yeah, yeah.
I said, you only an air traffic control.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Bruh.
Oh, yeah, the plan. Yeah,
bruh, the plan. I said to myself, that's why I got to quit. I quit. I can't do it. So I watched the thing. I God gave me a revelation. Humans just not going to do it. They just not going to do it right, period. They're not, and it's the ego.
It's the need to insert your own. That's what I'm saying.
For no reason at all.
That's the problem.
For no reason at all.
You said it, ego.
For ego.
Yeah, ego.
For no reason at all are you inserting anything of value. Mm. It's just like, and then here go the crazy part. I believe that the 90%, and I don't want to use the wrong term because people at the church might be like, oh, he trying to talk about me. I'm not. I'm talking about the movie. That's all I'm talking about, the series. That's it. Here's what I realized.
Hit dog, gon' holler. Nah.
Listen to me. Of the 90% of the people that went the wrong way, I believe only about 10 or 20% of them went the wrong way because they wanted to go the wrong way. Mm. I just put a video out, y'all. I don't know if y'all saw it. I put out a video when I was at a rehab in San Diego. I literally asked them, how many of your North Star was to be strung out on drugs? Mm. How many of y'all North Star? Like, you had a propensity toward becoming an addict. And they was like, of course not. One or two people was like, I was born. My mom was an addict at birth. Mm. So I was like, for sure.
But that's still not what you wanted.
Yeah, right. Yeah. But, right. But you do have a propensity toward it.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah.
So there are a group of people. There's a group of people. Only 12% of the world's population are pilots. So there's a small group of people that's going to do the, you know what, that when they want to do and they can't, you can't tell them none. That's it. I believe that 80% of the world is following the group thinking. So there's a group that don't want to make no decisions whatsoever, but because somebody made them feel stupid because they weren't inserting themselves, then they start inserting themselves. They didn't even have a desire to insert themselves.
Right,
but you're sitting down talking to a person who wanted to insert themselves and can't assert themselves, meaning you can't go do it on your own. You need to be. I had somebody today on the mastermind call just break out in prayer. and LDA said, hold up. You do not pray here. You are not Eric Thomas. You do not pray. You are here to learn. Mm. We had a conversation offline. You are not here to pray. Now, what you did was you paid to get in a community where you could pray. Because nowhere else do nobody want to hear you pray. No, and I'm not saying this to be disrespectful. Mm-hmm. You don't have a church. So you pay to come somewhere where your voice can be heard. Okay, cool. He gave you a chance to talk. Then you pray. He like, hold on. No. We want to hear Eric pray. Like, we didn't come here to hear nobody else. So do us a favor.
Yeah, and that's no disrespect to them.
Not at
the
all.
The other individuals didn't pay
to hear you pray.
Right.
They didn't come
here
to pray.
For Eric Thomas.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
So no disrespect. But what I'm realizing is you don't. If you had 100 people that you could pray with, you wouldn't even be on there. You wouldn't be here. But you paid to come somewhere to insert yourself. Right? And again, I'm not, to your point, it don't make you evil. I'm saying I want to show y'all the problem why you're not making money. So I'm going to show you the two things. So I was like, yo, you can't insert yourself. So I had a call with my squad about some work we about to do. And I could hear a little bit of like, okay, E, you got an attitude, or E, whatever. So when I got on the call, it was kind of like, E, we just want to do what you want to do. I said, whoa, hold up for a minute. Hold on. Let me be clear. I just want to be 1,000% clear with y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Please don't be offended. This was never I never wanted to do, no, don't get it twisted. Like, no. And I said, I see what the problem is. I'm two people instead of being like CJ and being one person. I'm two people. I present to you first the autonomy boy. You could make decisions. So then you make decisions, and those decisions are actually taking us in a way where ain't nobody about to be able to make a decision in a minute. I'm saying, like, we about to be in a situation where we not going to have no opportunities. And so I got to stop. And I said, let me explain something to you. Everybody, please hear my heart. I make money from speaking. CJ, I said, I've been doing this thing for, can't tell you how long. CJ came in and then we took it to a whole nother level. This has been almost, for me, it's been more than 20 years of speaking and getting paid. Mm-hmm. I know how to, I don't need no help. Now, I needed help becoming a household name. I don't need any help in terms of speaking. Mm-hmm. Like, that's what I know how to do.
Right.
And I know how to speak and get and keep getting them until Jesus come.
Yep.
I don't need to do this, and not only do I not need to do it, I'm not making no money doing it.
Yeah.
Every time we get a check, y'all get to eat. I don't eat. So if there's anything I'm taking personal, is your paycheck. As far as my wife is concerned, why are you doing something still and you're not getting a check for it? Mm. Why are we going? Why are you away from me for 8 hours a day for something that you're not even getting paid for? Like, stop. So I'm like, yo, I don't have a dog in the fight. I said, but what you have to understand is this. The reason why you're doing something and at the end of the year, they're not calling you back and you can give me all of these stats and all the stuff you did. It does not matter what you do. It doesn't. It only matters that the person that paid felt like you gave them what they wanted. It does not matter what you think. And some of y'all not getting paid because you still think it matters. So CJ said, nobody cares. I'm telling you, it does not matter how dope you thought you were, how good of a job. Oh, my wife, bruh, you think, bruh, I just had a 2 weeks of not having marital bliss, and I couldn't understand why I didn't have it. I'm like, what is going on? And my wife is like, I need you to, I'm saying, what? You need me to do what? She's like, yeah.
practice.
Right. I'm like, you need me to
do about practice.
What? And she like, you the one said you was gone and you still doing it. You said you was going to stop doing this. You still doing it. You said you was going to stop doing that. You stopped doing it. You said you changed this. Okay, you kind of changed, but you didn't fully change because you still, and now you said you was giving away my time and you said you was giving away my, and you said, and I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, you got, I guess you have a point, but I couldn't go, man, God. And I'm going to be, can I be real with y'all? I kind of told her without telling her, you know what I'm saying? Because I didn't want to seem like I was like choking or I was like making excuses, but I kind of was like,
it's working.
We talking about what?
It's working.
Look at your life.
It's working.
We talking about what?
It's working.
What are we? We in Venice.
Yeah.
We in Italy. What are we talking about?
I'm talking about.
What's the problem again?
On the gondola.
What? On the gondola ride. Like, you in a suite. You don't even know how much this suite costs tonight.
Yeah.
Like, have you? Do you? And God was like, you can say all that if you want to. She just
the one
told
grading
you,
the paper.
She just told you.
No. Listen to what he's trying to say, because I just had this conversation we had on Toby's side on the team. And somebody was saying, and shout out to them, they know who they are, but I was trying to explain to them, they were saying they were a master at one thing.
Yeah.
And they was like, yo, I feel like I mastered, but I'm not getting the props.
Yeah.
And the yeah, things and the I deserve. Yeah, no, for real. And they was like, yo. And I was like, good, this is healthy conversation.
This is great.
And I said, here go the thing. As it relates to this particular job, there's only one person whose opinion matters. So I said, and I literally gave this example. I could give you a million reasons why I feel like I'm the best two-man in the world. But the only one who can crown me that, unfortunately, is he has to say I'm the best two-man. So now, guess what?
Not my you.
Mama, I'm saying, I wish. I'm saying,
your mama yeah.
could tell me.
Yeah. Don't
Karl, could, Karl could even be like, yo, I ain't going to lie, see, I've been in this company with you for 17 years, bro. You are the best two-man. Maul could be like, yo, E tripping, bro. I feel like, and I said, it's only one person who can make that proclamation.
Yeah,
it's the one man of who you are the there two too. It's, that's the only one. Now, here's the thing.
Yeah.
We want, because we want partial credit, we will go to everybody else besides that person and explain to them why we actually are.
Okay.
And so I had to, do you understand what I'm saying?
Oh, loud and clear.
There's only one opinion that matters.
That's it.
And when I figured that out, I was like, oh, okay, cool. My job is to be the two-man for E for the rest of my life. If he doesn't feel like I'm doing a good job, I'm not doing a good job.
Right.
Don't matter what Candace said. Candace could stroke my head at night and be like, baby, you do everything right.
You're crushing it.
And you want to hear that. Yeah. Some of y'all want to hear that. You want to hear you're doing everything right. They tripping. I don't know why they don't appreciate you. You should be getting paid more. You should be doing this. You should be doing that. You can listen to all of that. And at the end of the day, that and $3.99 will get you a dozen eggs. Hey, I promise
I'm telling you. So these are my confessions. This is where we started. So.
Bruh.
For years, and it's so stupid because literally as we were sitting here, I remember the guy, when I started with the Big Ten Network, the guy told me one simple line that just played back in my head. He's like, yo, when you edit, I need you to be able to make a decision on every edit. And what he meant by that was, if I stop at 3 seconds into the video and there's a cut there, you should be able to tell me why that's there.
Mm.
He's like, if I go to 227 in whatever video you edit, you should be able to tell me, hey, I put that there because this meant that to me, or this felt that there's some reason that you put that there. See, all these years, that's why I said these are my confessions. And again, bro, for so many years, bro, I just needed the affirmation that that edit was good from somebody else. From somebody else. Truthfully, truthfully, it mattered here But really and truly, I don't even think our vote mattered. It's their vote absolutely. That mattered for that.
Oh, absolutely.
Our vote didn't matter.
Never figure out why you was tripping because the numbers was growing and it was great.
Yeah. But and I'm saying, these are my confessions. So now as we're saying it now, like when I sit to edit now, like I really go back to like, yo, Karl, and my rule is any editors that come to me now, I'm like, just promise me one. I got one rule. When you send it to me, it was your absolute best.
Yep.
Not perfect, not even right, not even fit the audience, but it was your best. You can identify every edit, tell me why you did it, and justify it.
Yeah.
And now, see, like, again, when I sit there, bro, there's still stuff that I'll send that y'all are correct. But I get up from that table like, yo, I just put everything Karl had into that, and watch this. I'm watching numbers grow. Bro, I don't need anything else no more. There's all of it in my confessions. Y'all never heard me say this. Bro, I was, for years, probably... I'd say a good 6 years, 7 years ago, I'm like, man, FC and E could only sit with me in one edit and understand what you just said.
Oh,
and understand what I'm going through and all the decisions and why it take me 24 hours to do 30 seconds. If they could only see all the things that I got to go through and find the right music and this and that. And today I'm proud to say I don't care anymore.
Yeah, thank you. And I was saying, and it's so funny, Karl, like when you're in my seat, and you got to make the decisions and drive this stuff, it becomes another job to have to, like, affirm you.
Yeah.
And like I said, it's not my – I'm not telling you it doesn't need to be done, but I'm saying, like, if I got to do my job, you got to do your job, he got to do his job, and then I got to come back and tell you, like – so for me, I'm going to correct it when it's wrong, but when it's good, just consider it done.
It's done.
But that's the pilot in me. Like, okay. I'm not even trying to be funny, E. How many times in our relationship, we coming up on 20 years. By the way, next year is 20 years. We got the 20, we're doing a tour, the 20-year tour. But, how, like, dead serious, how many times have you called me and been like, see, that great was job. A great job? I mean, on anything. I'm talking about, like,
none.
Mixtapes, books, none. Launches.
The only thing I would talk about is our relationship.
Yeah,
like but just I'm saying, the brotherhood.
Just in terms of like a regular day.
I'm not going to say, I'm not calling you and saying Jack.
I'm talking about y'all, listen, and it's 20 years. Now we might, like you said, we got a great relationship. We might talk and be like, man, God is good. Let's go. Yeah, we working. But like, never just like, hello, CJ, this is ET. Hey, man, that was a fantastic job you did. Never.
And I never made sure, like, the crazy part about it, and I told him this year, like, bro, I apologize. I ain't never made sure he got paid. I made sure everybody else got paid. Mm. I ain't never been, see, that you get the, that you, and I told C, bro, I had to be honest, I done gave away some of your money without asking you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I done gave people permission to take your money without asking and give it away. You know what I'm saying? So, to his point, it's like, no, I haven't done that because it is a thing of, it take time. And you know what's so funny about humans? This is why the show was so crazy. The crazy part about humans, though, is people would say you didn't affirm me. Nobody ever called and said, thank you for paying me on time.
Never.
Nobody ever called me and said, thanks for giving me insurance.
Never.
That's why I be tripping when people be like,
going through.
I'm like, I don't know why you offended. The thing you were asking me to do, you never even did that. That's why I came out with that thing. Y'all know if y'all remember that post I put out, but I was like, it's okay for you to quit, but I'm a monster if I fire you.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how sick humans are.
Yep.
It's okay for you to wake up one day and be like, you want to go somewhere else and do whatever.
I'm moving
but
on.
If I fired you.
Taking my talents to South Beach.
If I fired you, it's like, all this I've done.
Yep.
You weren't thinking about all you were doing when you left and went and got another opportunity or when you wanted to leave. And so it's like, I'm not saying you're right or wrong. I'm saying you need to know which paths take you to success and you know which path take you to failure. And you need to be okay with knowing if I want to, so I just want to say real quick so I don't forget the thought.
Mm-hmm.
I told them, here's where y'all confused. I only care about one thing. That's whoever gave us this check, they need to say at the end of this thing when it's all over.
Yep.
We gave them exactly what they asked for, and we gave them more than we asked for. Because for me, it's a waste of time to do something, and you don't see time because you're not looking at me being away from my wife because that don't mean nothing to you. And again, not in a negative way, but you thinking about you. But it's not okay for me to think about me. I got to think about you and I got to think about me.
And that's what I was trying to say. Now I got to do two jobs.
I got to think about you and I got to think about me and you not thinking about
me. And that's what I kept telling you, Karl, you were stressing me out with. Because I was like, I feel like you want something from me outside of what we already doing.
Right. Yep.
And that's why I never, like, again, I learned early on, take away stress, generate revenue. So what did I do for E? Make sure I was generating revenue, making sure he ain't never, I promise you, any stress that I caused E was self-inflicted by him. I think he said that a bunch. Yeah. But I have never in my life one time been like, yo, I did this. I ain't never called him and said, yo, me and Candace had an argument. Not one time in my life. I just refuse to bring him any stress. To this day, almost 20 years, I've never been like done anything intentionally or unintentionally that would be like, oh man, see, like he shouldn't have did that. Or he, you know what I'm saying? Like I pride myself on that. So I used to be looking at you like, Karl, like, okay, cool. And that's when we used to have our go-throughs was like, you're expecting something from me that I can't give you.
Right.
I can't, bruh, other than saying like, all right, cool, we got it done. We got the stuff out. Like, I can't come behind you after that and be like, oh, that was great. I can't call you every single day and be like, yo, congratulations. Like that, I probably could, but then I would take my eye off of whatever what I was supposed to be doing.
And I'm saying, and what's funny is, y'all, let me just say this loud and clear, y'all. Everybody in the back, please listen. When you do say it was good, bruh, it lasts about 10 seconds.
Right, yeah. Right.
Yeah, because it ain't nothing.
Let me just say it, y'all.
It ain't nothing.
Bro.
It's cotton candy. It's cotton candy.
I'm saying, can you cash that?
It's cotton candy.
Can you cash it at the bank?
I was talking to Jalen. I was like, he's like, Dad, I posted something. And I said, son, it's cotton candy. It has no, the applause of men have no nutritional value.
Ooh.
It's Cheeto Puffs.
That's a bar.
When somebody, congratulations.
Let me tell you.
It's Cheeto Puffs, bruh. Here's what matters. Am I in an industry? Am I killing it in the industry? Meaning, everybody, bruh, whoever becomes the president of the United States of America, just know this for a fact. Whoever becomes the president of the United States of America, at least 60 million people thought they was trash. The number might be higher.
No.
The number might be a little higher.
Bro, I looked at the thing last time. It's like exactly half.
Bruh.
I mean, whoever wins. Within the margin of like
1%. Whoever wins. 60 million, 65 million, maybe it's 70 million. Like 71 million.
Garbage.
71 million garbage. People thought you was good. Or maybe didn't think you was good, but you was the better choice out of the two. Now 70 other million thought you were trash.
Trash. But yet, you will be the president of the United States of America.
So for me, I don't trip on that. First of all, that's why I don't even be on the internet to that extent. Now, I be on it, but I don't be on it to be like comments and do all that. I'm not interested. What I'm on the internet to do is not even what y'all think. The reason why I'm on LinkedIn now is because I don't care if 257,000 people watch the video I put up on Instagram. It's probably not going to turn into a gig. So it's nothing that the 250,000 people liking my stuff is doing for me. I can tell you, though, on LinkedIn, that if you watch my stuff and you were in corporate or you were in the school, you have the ability to bring me
700 LinkedIn views is probably better than 280,000.
Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Instagram like.
Do you understand? So I'm like, yo, E, let's LinkedIn. These are grown, professional people. Ain't no distractions on. Ain't no entertainment.
You're going on there to look for opportunity.
They ask you every day. You want. So for me, it's, can I pay the bills? I'm a leader. So I wake up every month. Do we have payroll? I'm not worried about people's, we have payroll. Now, I was doing payroll for a minute and was like, yo, at the rate we going, every month, I don't like the stress of the way it's going. Like, okay, we ain't not paid.
350.
But, he exaggerated. 300. He done took it another 50.
I'm talking about 300. He done took it to another Spartan warrior.
He took it to another.
And I got to raise this shit.
And it's my job, though, the next month, not to say last month, we took a hit. So this is what I had to do. So for me, this year was like, yo, I'm not doing that. I'm killing everything that's killing payroll. Because I need to have payroll for months at a time so I can make decisions that are healthy decisions, not somebody say, we got $2,500 for ET to speak, and I got to go do the $2,500 gig.
To give it away.
Like, I can't do that. So it's like, it's got to at least be $100 for me to. So now, there was a $150,000 opportunity I said no to. Because I don't have to pay payroll. And I was never on that for myself, because I always, because of Didi, live all the way under my means. So I never had to do that. So it's like, okay, E, what's important? Definitely not what people are saying on internet. Can we pay insurance? Bruh, You understand every year insurance come back and say they got some new hookup and they want more?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't no 1 year and it don't never go up. Every single year, inflation goes to another level. Then we had 4 years. I don't know what it was. I don't know politically what happened. But we had 4 years where people weren't making no bread. I can't tell people I'm not going to pay you because people not making no bread. I still got to do what I got to do. So that's why I'm not interested in the man's applause. I'm interested in ADP. That's what I'm interested in. Hmm. I'm interested in Blue Cross Blue Shield. That's my focus every month. I'm interested in, yo, if we go out of town, I don't want to tell Cam. Cam was the one that found, and it was really, it's crazy. It was the St. Regis, which is crazy.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was the St.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, St. Regis. I was like, I didn't know Marriott.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't even know. Mm-hmm. But I know my wife, and I know what she going to say. But I know if she in the room where she can't see outside, it ain't going to be the same.
Oh, y'all food was crazy, too.
Bro, I'm like, I need the canal.
We're going to talk about that tomorrow, bro. We're going to get into that.
I need to see the canal. You feel what I'm saying?
Never mind. I can't. Because I want to ask you about it, because we ain't talked about it.
Yeah, yeah. So when Cam asked the question about cost, I was like, no. We're going with experience.
Yeah.
What would I pay for the Holiday Inn Express to be there? So I was like, if we're going to do it, let's do it.
Let's do it.
So I can't do that. Guess what, bro? I get back. Brandon like, E, we got a $25,000 gig virtue. Can you take that? I'm like, can I?
Come on.
Let's cover all the expenses from the Martini. He was the only one I was on there. Everybody else gone. I can't see nobody else's face. You got off on us. Come back. But anyway, yes. So I say that to say thank you. Come back. I say that to say bump all of that. Applause for man. All that. Bump that cotton candy. Bump hot Cheetos. You killing the lining of your stomach up in cancer. Bump lemonade that tastes good, but it's acidic. Don't do that. We have to start doing things that will clear the bottom line. So I told my group, yo, we're going down here, find out what she want, and we're going to come back. Here's what I said. We got a plan. I said, do me a favor. How do you have a plan and we ain't played the game? How do we have a plan and we haven't played the game? How have you already determined what we're going to do and we don't even know who we talking to? So let's get there. Let's do boom, boom, boom. When we come back, let's take this and dissect it all the way and let's make sure that we're meeting the needs. Because here's what I can tell you. At the end of the school year, first of all, she went with us with all of the stuff she had to go through with people putting out bad press. At the end of the year, I want everybody to put out bad press. I want them to eat I want them to eat it. Hear what I'm telling you. Hear this version of Eric Thomas. I want everybody to eat it.
Come on.
What I don't want to hear is no excuses about, we said we was going to do this and this happened and this happened.
Nope.
I don't want to hear it.
Nope.
Because if I hear that, it means ain't no more checks coming for y'all. Ain't no more insurance coming. Ain't no more you can get up and work when you want to. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no more you can take vacation when you want to take vacation. Ain't no more you can go work with other people and not just you can moonlight. Bro, when my mom worked for Ford, your dad worked for GM, bro, you can't have no other job. You can't be moonlighting, bro. So I'm trying to help you to moonlight. I'm trying to put you in a position to be able to go work for somebody else. We can't do that if you have to go back to your regular scheduled program. Mm. So we cannot fail. And so how does that happen? We find out what they want. We don't make no excuses. If you take they check, then give them what you said you was going to do. And so when they be dogging players out and stuff, and people be like, I feel sorry. They shouldn't be talking to so-and-so like that. I'm like, hey. I don't know. But all I know is Tom Brady looked at my man in his face and said, I will be the best decision
you have ever made
in your life.
Mm.
That's hard to say in the NFL. That's hard to say.
As a rookie
who got drafted the 199 or something. They probably got 203 opportunities. You got 199. But guess what I do know? I do know he did exactly what he said. And let me tell y'all why that's important. Because when you make excuses, you either get fired or you plateaued, period. When you tell somebody why you couldn't do what you're now telling them you're not dependable.
Yeah.
I can't count on you.
And that's the thing, y'all, is we're doing business,
yeah,
right?
We're
doing business. So this is what I say. Like, it's sad, bro, but I ask people all the time, what's your open market value?
Yes.
No, I'm just being real. Like, don't ask me as a small business owner, and regardless of what y'all think of us, we are a small, this is a mom and pop operation. We're not talking about how much E get paid to speak. We're talking about the business side of what we do.
Right.
Obviously, E does very well speaking. We're talking about the actual business that we run, a personal development company, Eric Thomas and Associates. We're talking about that. I ask people all the time, if you're going to work for a small business, at least, like, give me what your market rate is. Yeah. Now, you asking me for $75,000, $100,000, I'll pay you even more than that if you're worth more than that on the open market. But if you can only come here and you demanding something out of me that you know you can't even get in the free market, that's not fair. Because listen, this is all we've ever asked. At least cover your check.
That's it.
I don't even,
whatever that means.
When the last time we took a payout from ETA?
Bruh, I ain't took a raise from the day we started.
So my point,
you know how much money I make speaking? I don't see half of that money.
So, Karl, my point is, okay, cool. Just produce your check.
That's it.
Because I love for people to have opportunities.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like you said, insurance, be able to feed their family at a high level, vacations, trips. I want you to do all of that.
Yeah.
But don't make me pay more than the open market value. And if you find yourself wanting to make more, you got to be able to do more. You got to be able to deliver at that high level. But don't work for no small business and give me 75% calling in. You're not there. You're not showing up. You know you're not working hard because I'm not over your shoulder like you would be if you worked at a GM, Ford, or Chrysler. You can't just show up when you want to. I'm like, here, I'm just being real. I don't know what nobody's schedule is.
And I'm going to tell you why I work so hard. Because I want that. Like, I don't want to have to get up and go to nobody's job. I'm not against people that do it. I just don't want, it don't work for me. And you know why it don't work for me? Because it's status quo. It's like, we're up here killing it.
And my point is, either don't let it work for you if you work for us, like, decide that that's not the life you want either and work that hard or go get a 9-to-5.
Go get a 9-to-5.
We don't have no 9-to-5.
Yeah, and take the garbage.
We were talking the other day, like, bro, we've positioned ourselves where we have so many weekly things that go out.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, you talk about 8 years of podcast.
Yep.
You're talking about sermons. I don't know how long, bro, you've been preaching. It's years and years and years and years. Yeah. This stuff is going out weekly without missing a week. What time off? You just heard this travel schedule. It ain't no time off. We got to figure out. He about to be in China in a matter of days. Just got off a plane. We got to get it done. It's my daughter's birthday. It's just got to get done. We booked our flights for Barbados. We snowed.
When y'all going?
January, like end of January.
Good.
But it's like, yo, I'm in Barbados for 4 weeks. It don't change
nothing.
We
will get them pods
done. Yeah. Like, whatever we got to get done, it's got
to
get done.
Shout out to our Patreon family, man, making sure that we can get that done. Because let me tell you something. These flights expensive, dog. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being
definitely
real.
Definitely has changed.
Listen, flying up here, me and Maul flying, I mean, it costs us thousands of dollars to do every episode.
Like, it's crazy.
It's just like the price of flights, everything else.
Yeah.
Our Patreon audience, shout out to y'all. They watching live right now. Yeah. For real, man.
Y'all
little small
Thank you for being a friend.
Whatever they doing. Nah, I'm serious. I'm just saying, y'all got to understand something. We make decisions as a business and everything else. And if it's not something that's lucrative or it's not mutual, then at some point we would have to look at the podcast and
you
be like, all right, this ain't worth it. We're going
to
divert our energy elsewhere. But man, our Patreon fam has come through.
Y'all make it mutual.
Yeah, y'all make it mutual.
Y'all doing something for what we're doing.
If you out there and you listening, you ain't made it mutual yet. Shame on you.
Come on.
If you only been listening for 6 months, don't join the Patreon. Just continue to see if we feed
you. You on your third year. Talk about E. I'm loving the content, E. Bro, you've been listening for free for 3 years. $7 ain't gonna kill you, bro.
Yeah, and our Patreon members is laughing because they really rock with us. They watching us live right now. Y'all go to patreon.com/s2spodcast and sign up, man. Show love. We will have much more, including Dr. King joining us. He'll be back, man. We'll be back in our rightful places. I can't wait to tell y'all about all the great stuff that's going on. It's fantastic. Glad E could join us for this. We actually are going to Doc.
I'm over here locked into my co-host duties that Karl put me on.
Okay. I thought you might have had the TV
you
on in the background.
You feel me? You trying to get Doc in trouble.
I stepped away for a second and then somebody came in and was off mute. I'm like, dang it.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, I was going to text you about that.
Oh, yeah. Karl had to get up.
Yeah, tell me you had to use the bathroom. You had to use the bathroom.
Hey, love you, brother. Appreciate you, man.
Hey, for everybody else listening, we are separating the podcast from E's page on YouTube.
Yes.
So we do have a new podcast channel on YouTube.
Yep.
Go there. I don't know. We'll put a cutoff. I don't know if the next one or two episodes, but like we're going to move all the podcasts, all the old ones, everything new to that channel. So we just moving that. So
yeah, y'all please. Can follow our channel on YouTube too, man. Yeah. We need to get them YouTube numbers up. What is it? S2S podcast channel.
S2S podcast channel.
They got to put in channel.
Yeah.
Oh man, appreciate y'all, man. Love all y'all. Patreon. Appreciate y'all joining us live.
Yes, sir. Appreciate y'all.
Love
y'all.
We're gonna tweet y'all out. Send y'all out another. Yeah. Tweet it out. Whatever you
y'all
call
can
it.
See which one. See y'all. I'll be on the gram.
I don't do Instagram.
See
you
on the tweet.
I like Twitter. That's where I get all my news from. Love y'all. Organifi. Shout out to Organifi, superfood green juice powder, keeping us powered up throughout this pod. Go to Organifi.com, ORGANIFI.com, promo code SUCCESS. All right, get 20% off your first order. Y'all stay healthy out there. Stay blessed. We love y'all. We out of here. We'll
see you next week.
Let's go.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to the show, please, begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.